Hey guys, if you're an IT admin looking to automate the app packaging for Windows devices, stay tuned because in this episode, I'm going to be showing you the latest automation tools available, and I'll be highlighting a third-party tool called Simeon Cloud, which has a feature that allows you to automate the app packaging for Windows devices, leveraging Microsoft Intune on the back end, and it does allow you to push that out to one-to-many Microsoft tenants. My name's Nick, I'm a Microsoft MVP. Go ahead, subscribe to the channel, and if you like this content, go ahead and like this video. As we're going through the content, definitely scroll down below and let me know how you're managing application packaging today. Before we get into the automation tools, I quickly wanted to touch on three major pain points related to traditional app packaging. The first pain point is related to time consumption. Traditional app packaging is very time consuming because you're manually downloading the installation files, you're packaging them up for deployment. You're typically using some type of tool to broadly deploy them across devices like an RMM tool or something like SCCM, and then you're having to redeploy them every time that you need to update that application. The second pain point I want to talk about is complexity. When we're talking about packaging apps and deploying them to our organization, there's many steps that you need to follow, and there's a lot of ways in which this could break down from the application not deploying correctly. These are things like being able to define the install and uninstall files, understanding whether this is going to install in a system or user context, and being able to set some detection rules to know that the app has successfully installed on the device and get telemetry back about that. The third pain point I want to talk about is redundancy. Whether you're managing and deploying applications in a single business environment or you're deploying them broadly across many different environments, the steps that you need to take to configure and package an application is very manual and very repetitive in nature. The same is true whenever you're talking about redeploying or repackaging an app whenever you need to make updates. This is consistent whether you're a managed service provider or an MSP or an enterprise customer. The pitfalls I just mentioned really relate to a lot of the legacy methods of application packaging, but many of us have shifted into a more modern approach of application packaging leveraging a Windows Package Manager. You could think of a Windows Package Manager as just a hosted library of applications that are constantly being updated that you can actually tap into to both install applications and update them on the devices that you're managing. A very common and popular Windows Package Manager for both MSP and enterprise level customers is something called Chocolatey. Many of you have probably heard of this, but it is a library that you can tap into using the command line tools on a Windows device that allows you to install applications and update those applications as well remotely, and you do not have to then manually package files yourself. This allows you to tap into common apps that you would likely redeploy in a lot of environments, something like Google Chrome, for instance. Another popular package manager these days is straight from Microsoft, and it's called Winget. This is built straight into the Windows OS with later versions, and just like Chocolatey, it allows you to tap into a library of applications to both install and update those applications over time. This allows you to install and update apps that might not be in the Microsoft Store. If you're familiar with the Microsoft product line, you know that you can leverage Microsoft Intune to package up Windows applications and deploy them out to the Windows devices that you manage. Microsoft's recently come out with a native integration to Winget within the Endpoint Manager Admin Center with a much better user interface for deploying Microsoft Store applications. So it allows you just to pick the application from a catalog and deploy it out to your devices. And from there, it will keep it up to date as well. The limitation with this integration as it exists today is the fact that it only integrates with the Microsoft Store applications. There's obviously a lot more applications outside the Microsoft Store. Take Google Chrome again, for instance. That's a very common application we'd be pushing out to the devices in our organization. If you're familiar with manually packaging up files for Intune deployment, you know that they support both the Win32 applications and the MSI applications for Windows devices. MSI files are pretty straightforward, but when we talk about Win32 files, they get pretty complicated because you're involving a command line tool that you're using to package up an IntuneWIN file, which is basically all the installation files packaged up for Intune to understand how to deploy that out to a device. While you can get creative and use a combination of a package manager with the IntuneWIN files and deploy applications through Intune, can get pretty complex really quickly. Additionally, if you are wanting to push out applications to many Microsoft tenants, you still have a native limitation there as far as that package only existing in one Microsoft tenant. For MSPs, this means that you have to redeploy or repackage an application in every single Microsoft tenant that you have. And additionally, you would ideally like to push out these applications and leverage more of the other experiences within Microsoft Intune, like Windows Autopilot, So applications are deployed upon the unboxing experience versus after you've deployed your RMM tool, that's installed, and then it's installing the applications. For enterprise customers, there's a very similar pain point here where you're talking about repackaging or redeploying the applications across multiple Microsoft tenants that may be under the head organization, either through multi-regional expansion or M&A activity. And additionally, it's very time consuming even in a single enterprise tenant to think about managing the updates of those applications over time as well. This year, pain point is where a tool like Simeon Cloud can come into play and provide a lot of value. In the Simeon portal, you're able to add one or many Microsoft tenants here that you're going to use to deploy applications to. I'll then go under the App Builder section here and I'll select one of those tenants. This is the tenant I want to create an application in. You can choose from existing applications as well, but we'll get to that here in a second. When I click on New Application, I'm able to select the application type. There's Win32 and MSI. I'm going to go ahead and go with Win32 for this example. And then what you're going to do is download this blank or empty IntuneWIN file that we're going to use as a placeholder in Microsoft Intune or the Endpoint Manager Admin Center. So I'm going to go ahead and download this real quick. Then once I'm done, I'll click on Continue here. And then I'll be redirected to the Endpoint Manager Admin Center so I can finish up some of the configuration settings for this application. When you click on that link, you're brought into the wizard process here for adding a Win32 app. If you've done this in the past, this will probably look very familiar to you here. This is typically where you add your IntuneWIN file here that you've created via the command line interface that Microsoft provides. But in this case, since we're using Simeon, we're actually just going to select that empty IntuneWIN file that we just downloaded. So once I've got that uploaded here, I'm going to go ahead and modify some of these fields here. In this example, we're going to use Adobe as the application we're going to deploy. So I'm just going to modify a few more of these fields. And I'll go ahead and upload a logo. Once that's done, I'll click on Next. Here is where you can define your install and uninstall commands like you're familiar with as well. You can define the install behavior, the install restart behavior, and the return codes as well too. I'll select the operating system architecture here, as well as the minimum operating system. And then I'll define the rules as well too. I'm going to manually configure a detection rule here. So if I manually add a detection rule, I can choose between these three options here. And I'm just going to choose a registry setting here to put in for this particular value. I'm not going to add any dependencies here or supersedence in this episode. And then for the assignments, you could choose to add assignments here. But just note that we're going to redeploy this application across many tenants. So if anything, you wanted to make it more generic, maybe like adding all users or adding all devices or a certain group that you have in every single tenant that you're managing. For right now, I'm just going to leave this blank and continue all the way through here. That's definitely another option you can take as you're deploying these and then manually assigning them after they're deployed in environments. So go ahead and click on Create here. Now I'm going to pivot back to the Simeon portal since we've created this application. Back in the Simeon portal, I'll click on Continue here, and then I'll click Sync, which will just sync the existing applications over that I've just created and include that Adobe application. So I'll pause briefly and be back once this is done. Now the sync is complete, so I can click on Done here. And when I do, it'll load up the applications again that I just fetched. And down below here, I'll see the applications and I'll see the Adobe application that I just created. Below here, we have some additional options that are specific to Simeon as well that you can take part of. I won't go through them all here, but there's a couple that I want to highlight. One is the ability to automatically version the application. So this is basically saying that whenever the updates are made to the application or you've made a change to the app manifest, it automatically creates a detection rule to see if this version of the application has been deployed successfully in every tenant that you're managing or every tenant that you're deploying it to. Another popular one here is to enable the application install logging, which is basically adding logging to the install command line so that all the outputs go into a log file in a temp folder on the computer, maybe help you out with some debugging efforts in the future. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and click on Add File. I'm going to click on Add Static File. I'm just going to call this the Adobe EXE. And then I'm going to upload the EXE file I have for Adobe. Now that I have that here, I'm going to go ahead and click on Save Application. From there, you can choose to defer the sync or sync now, which will then deploy the application, update the application in your Microsoft environment and the tenant that you specified here. Once that's finished deploying, I'll be able to see a log of the sync here, and I'll be able to see the change detail, which includes the Intune application I just deployed, which is Adobe. Back in the Endpoint Manager Admin Center, you'll notice if you go back into your Adobe application that some of the properties were modified here as well too when that application was updated from Simeon. So some of these things here you can see, like the install and uninstall commands, as well as some of the detection rules that it added here as well. Now that I have this application deployed to one tenant, I can go into the reconciliation section here, and I can go into that tenant where that application resides. From here, you can scroll down into the Intune app section, and if I expand there, I'll be able to see the applications, and I will see my Adobe application, and from there, I can click on the three little dots, and I can click on apply to push this into other Microsoft tenants that I've added into Simeon. Now, for demo purposes, I've only added one, but if you had many tenants in here, you could select them all or select the ones that you wanted to push this application into, and it would redeploy it into that tenant. If you had not made any choice selections for the assignments, all you would have to do as a last step is go into those Microsoft tenants and assign this to the correct users, devices, or groups. After seeing that demo, some of you may be thinking, well, that's fine for applications that don't require any unique customer identifier to be passed in, but what do I do with the applications that require me to pass that information in order for it to install correctly? Many applications, especially in the MSP space, when you're thinking about deploying them to your customers, have a unique customer identifier that you need to specify as part of the installation file or as part of the installation command that you pass through. Simeon's actually solved for this, and I'll be showing you this here as a brief example, kind of like a summarized version of the last example. And we're going to be using SentinelOne as the application because that's very popular in the MSP space as an EDR tool. In Simeon, I can go under the sync section here, and I can actually click on the status to bring me into the DevOps portal here, which is basically the backend to what Simeon's doing to deploy these applications. From here, I can go under the repo section, and under the repo section, I can expand the source and resources here, and I'll see this config.tenant.json file. Just note that also up at the top is where I can filter between various tenants as well too, as far as their individual repositories. This is where I can actually define tenant level variables that will get passed in into the information as part of the app package file. So in this use case, I'm using SentinelOne, so I want to pass in a site token as well that is automatically configured whenever I configure the application. So in this use case, I'm going to go ahead and click on edit. I'm going to add a comma here, and I'm just going to name this site token. And I'm going to specify the site token for this particular tenant. Once I've done that, I'll go ahead and click on commit. You can add a comment here that makes sense as well, like adding variable for S1, and then click on commit. Once that's done, we can pivot back into the Simeon portal. From here, I'll follow the same steps to create a new application. So I'll click on new application here in the right corner. And I'll follow this through just as I did before to download the empty IntuneWIN file and pivot into the Endpoint Manager Admin Center. I'm not going to walk through the whole wizard just for the sake of time here, but just note that in the install command where we want to add that variable, in this case for SentinelOne, we have our site token here, and we're going to add the same exact value that we just added to our JSON file in the Azure DevOps portal there. So it has to match exactly here, and you want to put that as part of the unique piece of the installation command or part of what you're trying to actually define as your variable. So this is obviously how you would do it for SentinelOne because this is the install command I want to use, but this might look a little bit different depending on what application you have. The consistent piece is that you're using the same value exactly that you have in the JSON file. Once you've finished up the application deployment in the Simeon portal, meaning you've added the necessary installation file, the MSI or the EXE, you can come in here into the Azure DevOps portal again, open up that source folder, go under the resources and under content. And for this particular application setting for the variable we're going to look for, it's going to be under device app management and mobile applications. This will reference all the applications that we have in that Microsoft tenant, and we'll select the SentinelOne application here. And from here, you can see in the install command line, Simeon has rewritten this with the variable that we have created here as well. So instead of that being hard-coded, it's looking at our config.tenant.json file and adding this as the variable. So whenever you're thinking about deploying this to other Microsoft accounts, you can go ahead and push that out and then come up here and go into the repo for the particular tenant and just modify the config.tenant.json file with the correct site token in this use case. Okay guys, that's everything I have for you in today's video. Lots to unpack there, but you should be questioning how you're packaging and deploying applications today, and you should be wanting to learn more. I'll link below some of the cool open source projects that actually integrate with Winget, the native Windows package manager, and leverage also the IntuneWIN files to deploy applications through Microsoft Intune. If you're looking for more automation behind this, and if you're looking to take a single application package file and deploy it to many Microsoft tenants, definitely check out Simeon Cloud. You can sign up for a trial really easily, and they'll walk you through setting up your first application. As always, if this content is helpful, go ahead and like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments, leave those below. I'll see you guys in the next video.